Alright guys, here we have a system containing 2 kilograms of water, initially at 160 degrees Celsius and 10 bar of pressure. It's going to undergo an internally reversible isothermal expansion process, and we have heat transfer coming into the system, which is 2700 kilojoules. We're asked to find the final pressure in bar, as well as the work of the process, 1 to 2, which is some number in kilojoules. So to start things off, to find that final pressure, I'm going to need two properties at the second state. So at the final state here, our second state, we have 160 degrees Celsius and looks like we don't have anything else. Now, fortunately, because we were given the temperature and a couple of properties at the initial state of temperature and pressure, we have pretty much every property at state one, and therefore, and we also have the heat transfer, so therefore we could just use the entropy change to find the entropy at state 2, and then from there on we can get the pressure and everything else that we need. So now if we just define the change in entropy equation, we have the final entropy minus the initial entropy, S2 minus S1, equals the integral from 1 to 2 of the heat transfer, delta, lowercase delta Q, divided by T. Now in this case, delta Q is going to be the heat transfer at a part of the system boundary during which we have this portion of the cycle. Now, in this case, we just have a process from 1 to 2, so this delta Q can just be simplified as being Q, and the T would be the absolute temperature at the specific part of the boundary that we're at. Again, this is a pretty simple process, so we can just leave it as a regular T. And we're going to set that equal to S2 minus S1. And this is the formula that we're going to be using to find our, I guess, target would here would be the S2. So we can find the final properties and finally derive the pressure. Okay, so the first manipulation that I'm going to do to this expression is I'm going to break down this bulk form entropy to specific units, because that's what we have in the property table. So we'll have the mass times the specific entropy 2. Minus specific entropy 1, and those are lowercase s's, equals the heat transfer minus the temperature. And now I'm going to multiply both sides by T, and we'll have the mass times the temperature times the change in specific entropy equals the heat transfer. And now let's start plugging in our values. So we know that the mass is given as 2 kilograms, and the temperature is given as 160 degrees Celsius. But you're going to have to convert it into Kelvin, so you just add 273, and you're going to have 433 Kelvin. We're going to be solving for the specific entropy at state 2, and now we can just define the specific entropy at state 1. So at state 1, we have 160 degrees Celsius and 10 bar, so we'll turn to table A2, which is the saturated table for water. If we go to 160 degrees Celsius, we see that we have a pressure of 6.178. So because the saturation pressure for 160 Celsius is lesser than our given 10 bar, that means that we have a compressed liquid in this case. But if you go to the compressed liquid table, you're not going to actually find a pressure as low as 10 bar. I believe it starts at 25 bar. So you can just approximate, because entropy is more of a function of temperature than is pressure, so you can approximate the specific values by using the saturated liquid values. So if you ever need to use any of these values, you can just use the saturated liquid values for specific volume, internal energy, enthalpy, or specific entropy. So in this case, we're going to approximate that S1 equals, just about equals, 1.9427, and that's kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So we have 1.9427, and this is all going to equal the heat transfer of 2700 kilojoules. And now if you just rearrange and solve for S2, you're going to find that S2 equals 5.0605 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So now we have T2 is 160 degrees Celsius and S2 equals 5.0605. Let's go to the properties table and see where we are with that 5.0605. So if we go to 160 degrees Celsius, because it's isothermal, T1 equals T2, and we go to our SF and SG, so these two values right over here, we see that we had 5.0605, which should be in between both of those numbers. So therefore, we have a two-phase mixture. Because we're in the two-phase mixture region, this means we can approximate that our pressure equals 6.178 bar. So our P2, once again, is 6.178 bar. So next thing we can do is find that work. So remember that the work, we're just going to apply the first law of thermodynamics, is the change in internal energy equals the heat transfer minus the work. So the work from 1 to 2 equals the heat transfer minus the change in internal energy. And now let's break down the units of the internal energy into specific units. On a per unit mass basis, we'll have the work from 1 to 2 equals the heat transfer minus the mass times U2 minus U1. And now, just like how we did for the entropy, we're going to have to find the internal energies from the property table. So remember that state 1 is essentially a compressed liquid, so we can approximate using the UF value. So we're going to have 674.86 for U1. But for U2, we're going to have to find the quality of the two-phase mixture that we have here. So to do that, remember that S2 equals SF plus X times SG minus SF. And S2 we already have as 5.0605, and that equals SF, which is from the property table right over here. We have 1.9427 plus the quality, which we're looking for, is X times SG, which is right over here, 6.7502, minus, once again, SF was 1.9427. So now if you plug this into your calculator and you isolate for X, you'll find that X equals 0.6485. So it's about a 65% quality. So now we can use all of this to find the internal energy, which is equal to UF plus X times UG minus UF. And now we just have to use these two values right here. So we have 6.74 and 2568.4. So we have U2 equals 674.86 plus the quality was 0.6485 times UG 2568.4 minus 674.86. Plug all that in your calculator, you'll find that U2 equals 1902.82 kilojoules per kilogram. And so now we can finally start plugging in our numbers. So we have the work from 1 to 2 equals the heat transfer of 2700 kilojoules minus the mass of 2 kilograms times U2, 1902.82, minus U1, which is 674.86. Plug all of that in your calculator to find that the work equals 244.08 kilojoules.